the family tradition that was handed down to Puppy Dan, May's daughter. How did May Down School of Dancing first come about?
Well, my mother, when she was 14 years of age, her and another friend who was a very good pianist, Ella Bryan, my mother decided she would teach dancing in Little Hall in Ray Street, Fitzroy. And she went around to her friend, Ella, and said, come on, Ella, you're playing for me. And they started together. And then later on, my mother moved to Port Melbourne, and she was there for quite a few years. And when she was about in her 20s, 21 or 20-something, she came to the city. And ever since then, which is, well, I think we're in our 70th year this year in the city.
With your mother May being a dancing teacher, did you ever have any desire to do anything else?
Yes, I wanted to be a missionary. That was my ambition when I was a young girl. My mother wanted me to dance, and I came to class, and I was a little, I wanted to do it, but I wanted to do other things. You know what, like when you were in the Bijou, I'd find an excuse to go outside, and the usher used to let me sit in the theatre. I would rather watch it than do the hard work. But as I got a little older, and then I grew to like it, and then my mother was glad that she didn't really force me to do it.
It's all very theatrical here, and not just dancing, is it?
No, this is a theatrical school, so we give them the good basic training in all facets of dancing, but from the minute they step inside the door, we use the theatrical term.
It was May Down who actually taught you Tuppy's mother.
Yes, that's right.
Were there any people in the class faces that we'd remember?
Oh, I think so. Yes, Patty Newton, or Patty McGrath, she was then. Pat Carroll, who's now known as John Sayre. Yvonne Barrett.
You know, I danced when I was about 17, and I just adored every minute of it, loved it. Mm. You know, that's all I wanted to do was dance, and I think that's why I brought Louise, because I loved it, and luckily enough, she loved it.
It's a very rewarding in many ways. You have your heartaches. But it's very rewarding when you see children that you've taught and making the grade overseas and enjoying the work.
How much longer do you expect to teach for?
As long as I'm allowed to, from upstairs.